Guys, it's Daryl. It's Monday morning. I just made one video, another video on pollution and clean air. I noticed that the one before didn't get all that many views. It's something I feel very impassioned about, but I want to talk about something else now. I've come across a candidate called Andrew Yang. To be honest with you guys, I never heard of him before. I did not watch the Democratic debates. I'll be straight honest with you guys. I'm scared and fearing any future with Trump in it, but I think with a lot of other Americans, there isn't a lot of enthusiasm for the Democratic field, not yet, and that's scary. Andrew Yang popped up. He called himself the only candidate of color up on the stage. I think he's got an Asian background. This is the thing that caught my ear. He's not left, not right, but forward. I really like this. It's a simple soundbite, but I like the sound of it. He talks about a universal $1,000 freedom dividend for all Americans, kind of like a universal income. And nobody's crazy. I don't know. Everybody's very suspicious of stuff like that. But I started to listen to what he was saying about how we've lost so many jobs to automation. I think he was saying about something about 4 million jobs in the states of Wisconsin, Virginia, Ohio. I can't remember all the states, but he was talking about how we've lost a lot of jobs to automation. And that's been in the back of my head too. We have. Of course, people like Trump blame immigrants for taking our jobs. But I think by far automation, we've lost a lot of jobs to automation, to our technology is taking away a lot of our jobs. It's developing a lot of jobs too, but... And the way that he would pay for this $1,000 dividend, I guess it's a month, $1,000 a month for every American, which seems hard to do. But he was talking about a toll tax, more or less, on every Google search, every Facebook ad. So more or less, so the technology, we get some money back from technology. It's an interesting thought. I don't know. I have to give it some more thought, but... For one time, I just listened to him now. I don't know a lot about him, but I got to admit, I'm enthused. He's the one candidate that's caught my attention. I'm tired of just looking for an anti-Trump, of somebody that can beat Trump. I want a candidate that I can be enthusiastic about, somebody that talks about stuff that's important to me and is impassioned, not somebody that just bashes Trump or that might be able to beat him. This is something that inspires me, and this is what we need in this country. We need a candidate that's going to liven us up, that's going to perk up our ears. And so I'm going to read up more on him. This is just initially. I want to talk about something else too that's very important to me, is Social Security. I was trying to think what subjects are important to me, what topics, what issues in the 2020 election. If somebody asked me what's important to me, Social Security. I think with Donald Trump, with the Republican Party in general, their goal is to just do away with Social Security. Now, I talked to Trump supporters in my family, like I said, and this turned out to be very beneficial to me. Because it was one time, these people, I love these people more than anything in the world. And I had to sit there and listen. And I had to be open-minded because of my love for them, my caring about them. And it made me really listen to understand Trump supporters. I think the only way that we can get past this age of Trump is by looking into what caused this. And this brings me back to Andrew Yang and something that he said that stuck with me. He said that Trump isn't the problem, he's the symptom. And I've heard other people say that before, and that is the truth. So by me sitting down the other day and taking the time and having the compassion for the people I love to sit there and listen to these things that I don't agree with, but it gives me insight into what we need, what's lacking, what caused this situation that we're in now. One of the scary things too is, okay, my family's all hardworking, retired, hard, and the rest are hard, very hardworking, multiple jobs, working day and night. they don't have a lot. They don't have money in the stock market. They don't have investments. So the thing, I didn't bring this up, but what amazes me is a lot of these Trump supporters don't see the train coming down through the tunnel. They support Trump so much, but Trump is looking to do away with Social Security or cut it back or just decimate it to pay for wealthier Americans' tax breaks. People in my family, I'm wondering, like, what do they think? And what bothers me too is I've paid into Social Security now for 35, 40 years. I started paying into Social Security back in 1979 on a paper route. And that's how when I was 14 or 15, they took money out. I remember they took money out for Social Security. And I've been paying into it every stinking week since then. I'll be damned if Donald Trump is going to take all the money I put into there and give it to some corporation or some billionaire for whatever. You know, that's my money. That's money that I invested, money for my senior years if I ever make it. And this enrages me. And I don't understand how these Trump supporters miss this. I'm guessing that a large percentage of them don't have investments, don't have a plan for retirement. I don't know if they plan to work right up until their dying day, just drop dead and working and then be slid into a coffin and into the ground. I don't know if that's the plan, but I don't want it to be my plan. I've paid into Social Security for decades now, decades, every day, every week for decades. And I want that money back. And more than that, I want the insurance, the Medicare that goes along with it, because insurance now, I don't see any way that a retired average citizen would be able to afford that kind of insurance on their own. Medicare would be essential to health, to our health, to once you reach retirement age. That's one of the biggest things. Is the Medicare, and they're looking to cut all this stuff. I don't understand how Trump supporters don't see that by these supposed tax cuts. These tax cuts were supposed to be, I still remember Trump talking about it, giving a gift, a Christmas gift to everybody. And even people in my family were happy because it looks like to me he just they messed with the numbers so that you got a little more back in your paycheck, in your tax return. And the way I understand it too is that it's gonna, over the period of 10 years, it's gonna change, so that the same people that got a little bit more money the first year or two are gonna end up paying in 10 years, and it's gonna turn over more into a tax break for the wealthy and for the corporations. This is the way I understand it. And again, Donald Trump promised to pay down our national deficit. And it's now the highest it's ever been in I don't even know where it's at now. And of course, now down the road, they're talking about Social Security being the big boogeyman that needs to be cut. After they give the tax breaks, after he sneaks in these tax breaks, he turns around. Now he's going to turn around and blame Social Security and try to cut that and Medicare. And what I see is the average working American that's trying to save up, put a little savings in for their retirement, is going to be the one that's going to pay for all of this. While the top 1% just continue to thrive and get more money. That's what I see out of this. This is what scares me. This is an issue for me. And the 2020 elections is the security and stability of Social Security and Medicare. And like I've said in other videos, another top issue for me in the 2020 election is campaign finance reform. The situation where we elect, or we at least we think we're the ones electing these people, and as soon as they're elected, the lobbyists jump in and they have the ear of the politicians, and they're doing all the bidding of the corporations. It has nothing to do with us, nothing at all. We get the sound bites that say, that make us happy, But we get no action. These guys aren't working for us. They're working for the corporations. They're working for the most wealthy. They're working for the people that can pay into their campaign contributions for their next election. They're all looking like Trump. That's another thing that amazed me about Trump. He got elected in 2016, right? And almost immediately, he was raising money for 2020. You know, he was holding these rallies to get reelected in 2017. He had just got elected. This is a politician that is more concerned about his continuing career than he's concerned about us. This has to stop. And people don't even see, you know, a lot of these supporters don't see this. I don't know how they miss this. It's like they're not even concerned about Social Security or their future at all. All they're worried about is what Trump tells them to be scared of, what they should fear, brown people and gangs and M13. That was a big catchphrase back in the last 2 years. M13. Oh, man. Yeah, we need reforms. So I've rambled enough. Thank you for listening to this video. I hope you guys have a great Monday.